Good afternoon. This is Manas Ranjan from ATN Newspaper. Today I'm going to demonstrate about our core CSC project. That is, I choose as a merge solver. There is three number of project, but I choose merge solver as it is some tricky problem and want to solve this one. So this is my readme file and I uploaded in the GitHub. You can check it in my GitHub repository, that is public GitHub. Here I'm writing some commands and some information regarding the projects. This is name is a merge solver, and I solved this project by using backtracking recursion method. So we can also try to solve this project by using BFS as well as DFS. So how to install this merge solver in your local machine? In the Git, when you open this GitHub repository, you can find this. These are three files are there. One folder is there and two files. This is mazevt.exe, that is backtracking.exe, and second one is a readme, and one is the this is the folder inside this. So here I all the necessary information I mentioned inside my readme file. So you can see that here is a, if you want to install that, just download that this exe file on your local machine and install it. When you install it, it will given a extracted file as like mazevt.bt. These are the extracted file you can got in your local machine inside that extracted folder. So in here you can see that this is a mazevt.exe. This is a converter which I used in by using the Py installer. You can install any of the Python file by using the Py installer by writing this command. I just want to show, not going to install anything, just writing the Py installer. One file and your Python file name, that is merge.bt, anything file name .py, whatever the Python. This is the method of any command to writing or generating as a Python file into exe file. See, it will creating a dist and bm main folder. So you inside the dist folder you can find this file. So how to run this file? First of all, I want to go to my Python file. Here I want to explain something about my code. Here I using the backtracking algorithm, and here the main features of this algorithm, that we are passing the input file text as a argument parse. Arg parse is a module package which is of the Python package which is used for taking as a command line interface. So these are the command. This merge runner function will solve our merge, and the function will start running by taking the input from the arg parse from the input.txt, and I'm passing some slacks as a minus e and minus y. When I'm running this file, I will show you how it will be taking as a argument parser. So this is the file one and file two. File one is just opening by using the file system. I am opening this arg parse which is input.txt file, and file two is the output or whatever the path which is generated the output part. It is taken from the user, and then it will converted finding the length of the string, and then after it will directly going to solving the matrix by making a solution matrix and converting into 0-0 matrix, and then after solution matrix will be going to follow all the things. And another one extra feature I include here is this is a solution of the matrix, and one extra feature I include here is print direction. Whenever the solution matrix got the some one or zero value matrix, you can see that after the finding the solutions, it will directly showing the what is the direction means following. I used some of the basic logic functions. If there is a one, let's say I will visited by is false, it will convert it to true, means it will store inside an string as a down, up, left, right, means which direction it will follow, like one one. This is the input. You can see this is the formatted string which is given by the user input. It is an into n matrix, and what is the shortest path the merge follow to reach from source to destination, that concept is behind this algorithm. So I'm going to run my project. How can you run? If the user want to run through the command line interface, so if, before I want to explain something, that your Python has been installed in your local machine. That is the main necessary thing to learn this type of file, or else you can run by using the .exe also. I saw you the without Python file or without Python installation or with Python. If you have Python installation, just writing inside your repository, whatever the this is the folder inside my desktop project folder, mysv.bht. Just write here Python space, since my Python is already installed and set in the environmental variable path, so it will be directly taken in the any of the repository inside any of the file for folder directory. So the Python will be going to run through my this directory and writing as a Python space, what is the file name, that is maje. So maje bt dot py. Okay, since I am passing the argument files as a minus I is the input space, my input file I already show you as the input file I am already mentioned. You have to, the user, it is the already given, but you can change the input file, like here you can change it is a zero or same thing, whatever the input you want to solve the maje. This is the input file, so I'm passing this input file as a I input.txt, and it will generating a path. Since I am going to delete this path, it will automatically generated a new path, path or whatever the file name you want to keep, txt. It will, through the file system, it will return the output will be rot inside the path.txt. This is the output folder, and when you hit enter, some error is there. Maje bt dot, yes, you can check whatever the command is there. See, if you put maje bt dot minus h, you see there is a command not found. Why? Because I want to show you something. Python maje.py minus h. See, these are the helping commands already been written and giving as a argument you have to pass. So here is the input file as the output file. Since my input file in the same directory, so I am going to writing Python maje.php, and see, I am writing something minus I. Okay, since I am passing here output as a minus O, that's why it is not taking minus O. Sorry to this, and hit enter. See, it will showing nothing, but here one path dot txt file is generated, and here showing the all the, and this is the main. I will showing the extra feature that it will directly printed the direction that how it is following. I want to show something. This is the input, and this is the output. See, this is the input 1111100 0110 0011, and output is, it is all the matrices it will convert it to zero, and only the path followed is showing. So how from starting to ending followed, it is showing that from here is the starting point, it is going to down. So first is the printed down, then it is going to right, it is printed is right, then it is going to down, then right, then right, then down, then right, then down, then right. This is the reach to the destination. It is printed at the same time and everything. So how can I approach this problem? I just want to explain something. I install, I used the NSIS software to convert into the all the folder into in a single file, that is NSIS software, to package all the file into exe file so that user can install easily. And you can, user, if he, the user has not installed the Python on your local machine, so how can it run? Means just delete. I want to show you the output. This is the for Windows user, that is a bat file is there, and in this bat file just it is directly connected this exe file. So just double click on the bat file, it will taking the input. It takes 2 seconds to run this folder, and wait a moment. See, after 2 seconds it will generating a output for file. And another one thing I want to show you, as if the user entered the input in the last directory, which is zero, means there is no any path finding, there is no in the output destination is, there is no to reach the destination. So how, what is the output it will show? Just I want to show again, run, just double click on the bat file of the run, it will generated another, just 2 seconds, and this is the output minus one, means sorry, there is no any path available to reach the destination. This is the project for maje solver. I hope so you understood about the conceptual behind this, and you can read about all the things, documentation is there. Inside the documentation you can follow, and you can install for the, as well as the Windows operating system, as well the Linux operating system. and this is my repository. You can follow this. And thank you very much for the tenure and for our instructor, Priyans Srivastava.